I now give the floor to Elena de la Peña. Please, Elena.
Thank you very much, Christoph. It's a pleasure for the Spanish Road Association and for myself to participate in this interesting conference, and congratulations to the European Union Road Federation, the European Parliament, and the rest of the participants for this organization. We are firmly convinced that roads are key in the development of new mobility, and we need a safe and sustainable roads to allow new forms of mobility. This is something that previous speakers have already mentioned. Scooter cycling, which is very popular in some cities, in some countries, but not so much in others, and also the connected and autonomous mobility are part of these new mobility patterns. Next one, please. And today we are conditioned by the sanitary and the economic crisis we are living in this year 2020. And in Spain, as you will probably know, the situation is far from being good. There is an estimated unemployment rate of 21% for 2021, a reduction of gross domestic product up to 12%, and a serious impact in key sectors such as tourism, entertainment, and commerce, for example. And next, please. Yes, Hidar. We completely agree with the Nobel Prize in Economy, Eric Maskin. We will only get out of this with a massive investment in infrastructure. And for this reason, the Spanish Road Association has developed a proposal, and we have called it a plan for safe, green, and connected roads. These are concepts that have already been mentioned for the previous speaker. And it has been presented to the public opinion and also to the governments, not only the national government, but also the regional and local government. Our plan has been created to create jobs, would activate the economy, and would allow the adaptation of the infrastructure to the new mobility of the future, let's say electromobility, micromobility, and so on. And our plan is coordinated with the Agenda 2030, the Spanish strategy for safe, sustainable, and connected mobility, and it also fits in the principles of the European Recovery Program, Next Generation Europe. Next one, please. You can see in this slide a number of specific proposals that we have developed for rural roads. The first one is focusing on safety in highways, I mean single carriageway. This road network accumulates approximately 75% of the road accidents and victims every year in Spain, and I guess that is the same figures are also in other member states and other countries. We are proposing to implement the scheme 2+1, which is already working well in several countries, like for example Sweden, that you know it's a reference in road safety, but also in Spain and other countries. And apart from these particular schemes to avoid the frontal crashes, we are also trying to promote the concept of forgiving roads, which is part of the safe system approach. And this is a strategy to try to avoid or try to reduce the number of runoff accidents and their consequences. And in addition, we of course need to focus, as we have been doing for the last years, in the high risk road section that should be sorted out as soon as possible and if necessary by the in an emergency basis. And secondly, this is a very interesting topic for us and for the road sector as a general, is to try to promote that well-maintained roads can reduce CO2 emissions of vehicles. In the Spanish Road Association, we have developed some trials. We are actually working on this. This reduction can be up to 9%, the reduction of CO2 emission for light vehicles, or even 6% for heavy vehicles, if we compare a situation of bad condition of the pavement and the good condition of the pavement. So do not disregard the maintenance potential to fulfill the environmental compromises. Another programs we are trying to promote here in Spain is the adaptation of roads for connected and autonomous mobility. And you will see that we recognize that roads need to be updated for connected and autonomous vehicles, taking into account the different levels of autonomy. And this requires investments, of course, and the identification of priority roads. For example, motorways of the main road network that would be like the first part of the road network to be adapted to the connected mobility. We want to our mobility to be electric by 2030. Our colleague from DG Move presented a figure of 1 million points for charging for then 2025. And this is a very, very interesting figure that we should consider, of course. And well, if we want a mobility to be electric, we need to provide charging stations in rural roads, not only in cities. So electric mobility should be a reality, not only in the urban environment, but also in the rural ones. So this is, was also part of our plan. Again, in rural areas, we ask for support to improve the freight transport close to a small village and the populated areas. We'll maintain roads and a small logistic centers for freight storage and distribution, which will improve the transport performance, activate the economy, and create employment. And finally, in order to activate tourism, that you know that it's a very important part of the Spanish economy, it's time to promote local roads in rural areas and to adapt them to the safety requirements of vulnerable road users. That should be at the center of the management, of course. Next, please, you can check with this animation that we have proposal for safe roads, next green roads, and also for connected roads. Next one, please. Well, and here you can find a list of plan proposed for urban roads where new forms of mobility are a priority. We are considering in the first action improvement and enhancement of sidewalks and pedestrian area in order to allow safe cycling, walking, scooters, and so on and so forth. Second one, the construction of specific lanes for cycling and scooters. We want this type of mobility, but we want this mobility to be completely safe and far from other motorized vehicles to keep them separated from motorized traffic. We are proposing different approaches according to the size of these different cities. Another action is related to the redistribution of parking spaces in big cities. We are trying to keep them connected to the public transport if we want to keep vehicles out of the cities and the, out of the places where vulnerable users are going to have a higher rates of mobility. Another important topic is the low emission zones are also a reality in several European cities. For example, in Spain, we have a program, a political plan to implement them in all cities with more than 500,000 people in all the cities with more than 500,000 people by 2030. So we are asking to the governments to implement at least one third of them. And this will undoubtedly push new mobility patterns in these cities. The another action, again, massive deployment of electric car charging stations, which is necessary for them, our mobility to be electric. And we need to multiply the number of vehicles, the electric vehicles we have in our cities and in our roads today. And again, we should also talk about other alternative fuels, not only electricity, but it's and today it's one of our priorities, but we should consider other alternative fuels. And finally, we are also proposing priority dedicated lanes for high occupancy vehicles. Some solution requires the construction of new lanes with high investment, but others will use the existing infrastructure and will be based in the use of intelligent transportation systems. And again, next please, there are plans linked to safety. Next, click please. There are some plans linked to safety, other for green roads and another ones for connected roads. And finally, next please. And finally, let me share with you some impression about the impact of these plans. We have estimated in Spain an investment of 32,000 million euros, which is not a small amount for the 12 plans that I have briefly presented. And we are thinking, we have estimated that a creation of 1 million new jobs, direct and indirect, that are probably going to absorb part of the unemployment that we are going to have in other sectors. We are trying to activate the economy to support the mobility and the future, and as a priority, keep transport safe and sustainable, especially for vulnerable road users. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Elena, and sorry to rush you a little bit. We need time for the others. Sorry. Thank you. Very interesting presentation. We will debate later. So, Jan, now the floor is yours.